Hi, I'm Brian Malow. Are you like me? Every day I have new questions about the COVID-19 outbreak and how to respond to it, how to feel about it. There's so many conflicting stories and rumors. So I've partnered with Sigma Xi, the Scientific Research Honor Society, to conduct a series of interviews so that I can ask experts and get up-to-date, research-based answers to my questions. I'll be presenting long interviews as well as short excerpts as fast as I can get them out to you. You can find the videos on my own social media channels, Science Comedian, as well as those of Sigma Xi. Thank you. During this time of social distancing, when we're trying to slow down the spread of the coronavirus, dining in restaurants is off the table. It's a high-risk behavior, according to experts. So a lot of restaurants have been offering takeout and delivery service. But is that safe? I spoke with Dr. Benjamin Chapman. He's a professor and food safety extension specialist at North Carolina State University. We discussed many aspects of food safety, and I'll be sharing more of our conversation soon. But my very first question was, is it safe to order food for delivery and takeout? Depending on how long this goes on, a lot of businesses may not survive, and so we can help support businesses. But what's the risk? Are we, Is that, undoing the good that we're doing by staying separated if we're having delivery people go door to door?
So I think the risk is really, 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 really low. And hopefully that provides a little bit of starts to push the fear away of this. So let me talk about a few different things. One is, it's really hard for me to tell somebody or answer, like, how worried should we be or how concerned should we be? This is a really personal question, right? Like what I do, and when we talked a little bit about, like, food safety and food safety extension, a lot of what I do is outreach and education around risk. And this situation, it's still a very similar thing where I really don't want to tell somebody who's very worried about it, you know what, you shouldn't worry about that. Because I think you get into a weird, like, trust and power situation. So my goal is, like, all right, the second part of your question was, like, what are the risks? And so let me start there. The risk is really, 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 really low. In fact, every indication that we have from historical data on other coronaviruses, so SARS and MERS, similar virus, not exactly the same. We've never seen food or food packaging or food delivery be a risk factor for infection or illness, developing illness. And that also kind of is in line with what we're seeing epidemiologically with this specific virus. So a lot of what I'm seeing, like what I'm kind of in a weird spot on right now is, most of the time people are coming to me about an outbreak of E. coli that's linked to romaine lettuce, for instance, and saying, how did this happen? How do we prevent it? Today, a lot of the questions are, why isn't this a food safety issue?
Yes.
This situation with COVID-19 is really interesting because the virus also could be there on food. Like, that's sort of the nuance of the answer to what's the risk. While the risk is very, 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 very low, in fact, we have no indication that food could be the source. Could we have virus, COVID-19, on food? Yes. So part of the reason why we believe that consuming food, so let's say, doesn't matter how it got there. Someone coughed on it, someone's hands put it on it. When that pizza got in your box, something happened after it was cooked. Let's just assume it's there, right? Like, don't worry about how it got there. As you consume that food, the virus, and this is really the biology, like, wow part of things, the virus itself doesn't like all the cells of our body the same. So our cells have different receptors on them. And this virus, coronaviruses, that class of viruses, really want to infect respiratory tract cells. So once it's in my mouth and goes into my esophagus and into my stomach, I don't have a whole lot of respiratory cells that it can infect. Then as soon as it gets into my stomach, the pH, the acidity, the pH of my stomach drops. Like, you know, up here, we're in the 7. When it gets down into my stomach, we're now at 2. And the virus itself doesn't like to be in that environment. The protein coat that's on the outside of this will start to denature or open up. And it just doesn't, it's not the right environment for the virus.
If I get a pizza delivered or any food delivery, should I do something to wipe down the bag or the pizza box? How risky a thing is that as far as we know right now?
Yeah, so very, very low risk. We actually have no data to show that food packaging or food itself is a route of transmission.
But the packaging is a surface, right? Like, so is that not a surface that it could exist on?
It is a surface. It is a surface that it could exist on. It's not what we would call a high touch surface, which is really the surfaces we're concerned about in this outbreak. One thing you can do with delivery, takeout food, with packaging is wash your hands after you handle that, and that will break that mode of transmission.